إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل فقد فاز المتقون وأذكركم ونفسي بقول الله تبارك وتعالى واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. Dear Muslims, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who reminded us to think of the day in which we will be returned back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and every soul will be paid what they have done. Time is passing and every day we can see ayah after ayah, sign after sign. When the wife of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam died, Abdullah bin Abbas, when he heard, he made sujood. And they asked him why. And he said, when you see an ayah, you make sujood. And when the good people are dying, it is a sign. It is an ayah. Because the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, La taqumu sa'atu على أحد يقول الله الله. By the time the Qiyamah comes, we can imagine how far mankind will go and how much they will be denying the truth day after day, to the extreme that you will not find one person mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we can see it from now. There are people who are debating globally to prove that there is no God, and you don't need to say that word. It means every time good people are leaving, the prophets have gone, and the awliya, and some of our parents and elderly people, teachers and students are dying and going, and they're leaving us in this dunya, the dunya that Ali bin Abi Talib said about it. إن هذه الدنيا حلالها حساب وحرامها عذاب. This dunya, whatever you get in it, whatever you earn in it, in the halal way, you are still not safe because you are accountable for that. Those people who did everything in halal way, still they will be accountable. How did you earn it? And how did you spend it? وَحَرَامُهَا عَذَابٌ. And when we go through this life and earn in it in the haram way, it is a torture, it is pain in dunya even before the akhirah. This dunya with Ali bin Abi Talib رضي الله عنه say, أَوَّلُ مَا تُغْلَبُونَ مِنَ الْجِهَادِ هو الجهاد بأيديكم ثم الجهاد بألسنتكم ثم الجهاد بقلوبكم فإذا أصبح الرجل لا يعرف المنكر لا يعرف المعروف ولا ينكر المنكر عكس قلبه نكس قلبه فصار أعلاه أسفل. The first thing, type of jihad, will disappear from the life of mankind is the jihad with the force. Those people in power, they will not have power anymore to stop what is wrong. And the next one they will lose, those who can say it at least, let people know that this and this is wrong. A time will come, they will not even say that. And then a time will come, they will not even believe in their heart that is wrong. They will accept it even in their heart. The minimum jihad. And when somebody's heart goes to that level, it goes upside down. And we are still in the madrasa, in the school of Luqman, learning when he was reminding his son with his social responsibility. Ya bunayya aqim as-salata wa'mur bil ma'ruf wanha 'anil munkar wasbir 'ala ma asaba. Oh my son, take care of your salat. The most important relation between you and the one who created you, between you and the one who allows your heart to pump 70 times per minute to supply your body with blood, to supply your brain with blood so that you can live. Stay with him. The one who is taking care of all of these things, before he tell you, take care of your heart by yourself. Take care of your lungs by yourself, or your kidneys by yourself, and one will become employed without any pay to take care of your own organs. And we cannot do that. And the doctors cannot do that. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do that. He was reminding his son. And what a lovely relation in this type of families. What brings them together is the truth. And when there is something wrong, they are honest to each other. That is a real fatherhood or sonhood. Oh my son, take care of your salat and tell people to do what is right and promise the good things among the people. Wanha 'anil munkar, and forbid what is wrong and evil and do not promote it. Wasbir 'ala ma asaba, and be patient, because when you start to do that, you will face a lot of criticism and problems, and all the shayateen will load their weapon and aim you. But don't give up. Why? Because inna dhalika min azmi al-umur. Doing these things, not something that you will say, if I want, I do it, and if I don't want, I don't do it. No. It is order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Order from him for us to pray 5 times a day, the minimum. And take care of our social life and keep it the society of the believers, not the society of the hypocrites, with the Holy Quran described. Al-munafiquna ba'duhum. Al-munafiqatu wal-munafiquna wal-munafiqatu ba'duhum min ba'd. Ya'muruna bil-munkar wa yanhawna 'anil ma'ruf wa yaqbiduna aydiyahum. Nasu Allah fa nasiyahum. Innal munafiqina humul fasiqun. This is a social life of hypocrites. They tell each other to do what is wrong. And if anyone tries to tell them to do what is right, they will be against that. That's what they want. وَيَقْبِدُونَ أَيْدِيَهُمْ. And when you ask them to contribute in anything for the welfare of goodness, they will pull back their hands. They don't want to be part of it. You ask them, put your money and save it for yourself to build a masjid. They don't need that. But to build a place for entertainment, they will go for that because they want to entertain their life. This is how munafiqeen live their life. Nasullaha fanasiyahum. They forgot Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah forgot them. And forgot Allah means they did not take him serious. And they dare to face the consequences of forgetting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make them not candidate to his mercy. And that is their choice. They decided to live their life according to their low desire, not according to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They believe their mind can guide them to the best way of life, not the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى أَنْ رَآهُ اسْتَغْنَى. Men go beyond their limits when they think that they are rich and they have knowledge and they are such and such. That will lead them to what? To follow the method of Iblis. And what was his method? He doesn't listen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the order to do something and he didn't listen. And this is, if somebody wants to become a shaitan, we start to reject the orders from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the advice from the elderly people, the advice from the parents, the advice from the teachers, we start to say no, and we don't listen to them. And that's what Iblis did, and he changed his destiny by himself with his choice. He was good, but one day he thought he has grown up, and he start to live his life the way he wants. And we know what happened after that. He became cursed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the social life of the believers, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتُ بَعْدُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْدٍ, the believers, both male and female, they are the caretakers of each other, the bodyguards of each other, the protectors of each other, the teachers of each other. And how does that work? يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, they tell each other to do what is right. وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, and they forbid each other to do what is wrong. وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ, and they take care of their salat. وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ, and when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them wealth and puts the money in their pockets to test them, they remember, Allah gave it to me to test me, and he told me to pass it on to those in need. So they pay the zakat. وَيُطِيعُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, and they obey Allah and they obey the Rasul, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أُولَٰئِكَ سَيَرْحَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ, these are the people who Allah will bestow his mercy upon them. This is the social life of the true believers. The social life of the true believers, الْمُؤْمِنُونَ بَعْدُهُمْ لِبَعْدٍ نَصَحَ, the true believers to each other, they advise each other. They don't expose each other or hate, but they advise. Even when they make mistakes in a very beautiful way, they will remind each other. This is the sifa of the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam and all those who follow him. وَالْمُنَافِقُونَ بَعْدُهُمْ لِبَعْدٍ غَشَشَ, and the hypocrites, they are disloyal to each other. They will not advise you, but they will destroy your name behind your back because they don't have iman. They try to knock down your glory in order to build their own. But a believer believes that the only glory comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whoever Allah put down, nobody can put them up. وَمَنْ يُهِنِ اللَّهُ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ مُكْرِمٍ, so we have social life in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask each and every one of us on the day of judgment, what have you done about it? Luqman and his son will remain truly a family that we all need to look up to. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that family life in the Quran. So a father can take an example, and also a son or daughter can take an example from that. And in one of the hadiths of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, in Sahih Bukhari, when he said, مَثَلُ الْقَائِمْ فِي حُدُودِ اللَّهِ وَالْوَاقِ فِيهَا كَمَثَلِ قَوْمٍ اِسْتَهَمُوا عَلَى سَفِينَةٍ فَصَارَ بَعْدُهُمْ أَعْلَاهَا وَبَعْدُهُمْ أَسْفَلَهَا فَكَانَ الَّذِينَ فِي أَسْفَلِهَا إذا أرادوا أن يستقوا من الماء مروا على من فوقهم فقالوا لو خرقنا من نصيبنا خرقا ولم نؤذ من فوقنا فإن أخذوا بأيديهم نجوا جميعا وإن تركوهم وما أرادوا هلكوا جميعا. This is the example that telling us what happens when people live together, and some of them, they want to do something wrong, but others are able to stop them, but they didn't do it, they let them do it. When people in one arc, one on top, some on top and some underneath, and those underneath, whenever they want to drink the water, they will go up and tell those on top, so they want what they will get it from there. But they thought, what about if you make a hole right here from underneath? So we don't have to go up and down every time. If those people tell them, yes, go for it, what will happen? The water will come into the boat and all of them will die. The good people and the bad people. The same thing in our social life. When we say, this person did this and that, nothing to do with me, it is wrong. We have a social responsibility, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Holy Quran, in Surah Al-Imran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ O you who believe, fear Allah, and observe your duties towards Him the way you're supposed to. The way we're supposed to fear Allah. Correctly. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ And make sure by the time death comes to you, you are a believer. You are ready to go. And we know what death means. Something that reminds us to talk to ourselves and say, أَلَمْ يَعْنِنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْ تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ You're thinking of death. The death that made Uncle Habibur Rahman not to pray with us Friday, today, and last week. And the one before he did. That was death, die. Take away those people who we love, and they used to remind us as elderly people what they have been through in life. And when young people are wise, they will listen from them. But if we don't, they will die, and we bury the glory with them in their head in the ground. And it's good for good. We need to be very close to the elderly people. They know what we don't. That's what death does. It reminds us to say, Ana ya nafsi, O myself, it is time. And akuna salihan fi a'mali, to improve my deeds. Do good ones. Sadiqan fi a'wali, to be truthful in my words. Mustaqiman fi mabadi'i wa a'ra'i, straightforward in my principles and my views. Death reminds us to say this to ourselves. It reminds us to say, Ana ya nafsi, an ahbisa nafsi, fi qal'ati al-iltizam bil qiyam allati amantu biha. It is time for me to imprison myself in the castle of the values that I believe in. And that values are the values of Islam, the divine values from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Death, what it does, it will turn our intelligence that in our brain. When it comes, it makes that brain become a rotten jelly in our temple. We cannot use it anymore to think what is wrong, what is right. We cannot use it anymore to store the knowledge of Islam. Death that will turn our tongue that we used to have and say a lot and talk a lot, except the good words we don't say. Backbite people, put people down or hurt them. Death will come. Turn it into a piece of dead rotten meat in our mouth. Death that will run the water out of our eyes and we can no longer look at what is right. Look at the Quran and read. All these chances are over. That's what death will do. It took uncle away, but he's in our heart because we learned a lot. And every time the good people go, we say to ourselves, don't be sad, it is okay. When good people die, we should not worry. But when the time passes, we start to miss them because we really need them side by side to learn more from their experience in life. And the Holy Quran told us, make sure that before death comes, you are a believer. You are a true Muslim. And in order for that to happen, we have to struggle on a daily basis to keep Islam in our life, in our behavior, and everything else. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا How to make a social life very strong in one way is when we hold on together to the rope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lowered to us to hold on, the Quran and the way of the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. If we leave that, what will happen? وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا We will go apart, everybody going in different directions. Why? Because we are not united with the divine law that brought us together. The divine law that brought all the prophets together, all the true ulama, they used to be together with that. And Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik,
Imam al-Shafi'i, Ahmad bin Hanbal, rahmatullah alayhim, they used to be together. Why? Because with their opinions, they all take it from way, the Quran, and the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam. وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا, don't go apart. وَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ, and remember the ni'mah, the bless, the bounty of Allah on you. إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً, you used to be enemies to each other. You used to look at each other through your colors and tribes and nationalities and tongues and languages. And that is over with Islam. فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا. All of you have one heart now. And what brought this heart together? It is the Quran, the ni'mah of Islam. وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَى شَفَى حُفْرَةٍ مِّنَ النَّارِ. The way you used to live your life, you are on the edge of Jahannam. فَأَنْقَذَكُمْ مِّنْهَا. But through Islam, you have been saved from that. كَذَلِكَ يُبَيِّنُ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ آيَاتِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ. All of these verses and ayat, it is clear to you, so that maybe you will be guided to the right path. And the right path is the path that the Holy Quran is calling us every day to. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّغَ بِكُمْ عَن سَبِيلِهِ. And then the ayah continues to say, وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Let there be among you some people who will dedicate themselves to learn about the Sharia, and they will help the other people. And Surah Al-Ahzab explained it. Surah Al-Tawbah. وَمَا كَانَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لِيَنْفِرُوا كَافَةً فَلَوْلَا نَفَرَ مِنْ كُلِّ فِرْقَةٍ مِّنْهُمْ طَائِفَةٌ لِيَتَفَقَّهُوا فِي الدِّينِ وَلِيُنذِرُوا قَوْمَهُمْ إِذَا رَجَعُوا إِلَيْهِمْ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَحْذَرُونَ. There should be some people who will dedicate themselves to learn properly and be qualified enough to pass on that knowledge to other people. Because we all cannot focus on one thing. It is fine and duty for some people to focus on medicine, on politics, on science, and so on. Yet, they will be in touch with the scholars of fiqh to know how to live their life. So we need everybody with their qualities in every society. And after these verses, when you do this, tell mankind to do what is right, not what is wrong, then we deserve to be what the next ayah says. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. If you do this, O Muslims, then you are the best nation that has been sent out for the rest of mankind. Not because of anything else, not because of the blood or the race, but because of the qualities. And what is that? We say no to what is wrong, and we support and say yes to what is right, and help people to do good. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Hakim, wa ja'alana wa iyyakum min alladhina yastami'una al-qawla fattabi'una ahsanah. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullaha li wa lakum fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. Alhamdulillah thumma alhamdulillah. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. عباد الله, قال تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Dear Muslims, we all have mistakes in our life. That does not mean we say I'm not good, so I will not tell others what is good and right. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to use us for what is good and right. And one of the poets said, لَإِنْ لَمْ يَعِذِ النَّاسَ مَنْ هُوَ مُذْنِبٌ فَمَنْ يَعِذُ النَّاسَ بَعْدَ مُحَمَّدٍ. If someone who is sinful cannot remind others to do what is right, who else other than Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam will tell mankind what's right and wrong, because he is the only one who has no sins. We all have it, but we ask Allah to cover us up so mankind don't see the dark part of our life. Maybe through that they will listen to what we say. Otherwise, we may be saying dead words. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use us for his deen and use us to help and save our families and our society through al-amr bil ma'ruf wa nahy anil munkar. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا واقض الدين عنا وعن المدينين. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر.